fell from a height and then got to die.
No, it was the first game that...
Oh, you finally played Halo 5?
Yeah, I told you.
Yeah, but I was like, I'd forgotten. And I'm against just make conversation. Yeah.
But yeah, I did.
Disappointed?
Yeah, I wouldn't say that. It didn't disappoint me as much as I expected. I say that the advertising meant royally screwed up. Like, if they had just gone with trying to advertise what the game was about, it would have been fine. But they really screwed up because they focused on some of the aspects that was actually part of the game. But no, Halo 1, I really loved it. It really hit me there. And even now, go back with the I actually played it again with side. And we went through a puzzle, and I was going through the puzzle, and I'm like, man, I feel like I'm like, oh, they did a really cool thing with foreshadowing here. But,
my mom
man, I feel like my mom.
My mom does like the small part. My mom does like that.
But I thought it was pretty cool. Like, I have to say, my teammate has a problem on that. It has to be a silent version. It's the most combat oriented on the D1, where you still have three stops going on the internet. I'm about to say, is follow up. And you know why, not all of them. All of them is cool, right? But alright, so no. you say that no one plays Fallout games in this story. I do.
Yeah,
and
well...
here's the thing. I played Fallout 3 for a long time. And as a matter of fact, when I first started playing Fallout games, it was actually my preference. I did prefer Fallout 2 Vegas.
Yeah, it was a joke.
Yeah. I'm not serious about it. Yeah, but no, like, I did enjoy Fallout 2 Vegas in game 4. It was more solid gameplay-wise. Actually, no, you can't make down the iron sights in that one.
Yeah, but anyway, why is Fallout 3 important?
I had played it for a very long time. It had been the first actual post-apocalyptic game that I had enjoyed, and it kind of got me really in that way. And I enjoyed the characters, I enjoyed the environment, I enjoyed the monsters, no matter how much I fucking hated the stupid scorpions.
Yeah. But, and I will say, post-apocalyptic
is important to the art, right? Yeah. But and it was when I fought, this had been, I'd have to say,
why it was a trip. Yeah.
But when you're fighting
something that big.
No, that's you don't notice that. That doesn't even go.
So, this had, I'd say this probably, this had been the longest game for me to beat, aside from 2 days. But it had been the longest game to beat, and I finally got to the end. I'm going to put up a spoiler warning here for those.
Yeah, spoiler warning for these games.
Yeah.
So,
you get to the end, and you're putting in the code for your father, and after, you know, you see your father die. I walk in there. I try to think of, like, okay, what did the code be? And I start looking through, like, my notes and stuff, and I go to the very first one, and it's the note of the Lone Wanderer's mother of her favorite Genesis. I won't say what. And I looked at that, and I kind of choked up because I just thought that was a really touching moment, because it just really hit me, and putting it in, I felt like as the lone wanderer, I had accomplished this character's goal of completing their path thing and being able to sort of lay them to rest and do that and all that stuff. And it was really nice, and I really enjoyed it. And then I'd have to say third, Knights of the Old Republic, another game I played shit long time. Haven't beaten it yet, still need to. And then, I don't know, the rest of them, there are some that I can note, but those are the most important.
I took a whole week off of work with Technicolor and Roxas just to play that game.
You slide up
when you're like officially. Yeah.
The Switch.
The whole Switch conference, I was.
You're trying really hard not to, and like they announced Breath of the Wild and you lost it.
Yeah. Also, I'm gonna take my purpose. I like thinking it's just that circumstances don't allow it to happen a lot, and
dude,
with, between those guys, they change slightly as
no
people,
one deny I'm good at this game
slightly
is
awkward.
It?
Well, hell no, you
yeah,
are awesome
again,
at this game.
They're like slightly different people, and I don't know what to say.
I don't know. Yeah, since I do have a sad backstory, unfortunately my brother and I bonded a lot over that.
Me and my sister divided over my sad backstory.
Yeah. I don't know. Sadness either brings people together or drives them apart. And I feel kind of like it's a roll of the dice on what happens.
I think I'm not sure
to do with you or not. Yeah. Not gonna gonna lie, I hated my brother for a very long while, and then it was just kind of randomly recently. It was when I moved out for a bit that I, like, suddenly went, yeah, no, my brother's pretty cool. And my brother suddenly realized the fact that I am getting older and I am going to be.
Pretty soon now, huh?
Yeah. And then I'm moving out again. It's, like, my family doesn't know. Because it's easier if I just kind of leave.
Yeah, not.
And I feel
probably,
bad for my. Yeah. I feel bad.
My relationship with my parents at home.
Yeah, this is gonna be a super long episode. It's all like one episode.
Information to
yeah, unfortunately.
Hang on. Hold on.
Alright, so.
I will say, my relationship with my parents at home
by the
about
way.
Moving out is slightly different. We both agree that if I don't move out soon, it won't be healthy for either of us.
Yeah.
Because
your mom's not gonna want you to move out soon.
She wants me to move out soon, but
on the
also
scale,
there's
like,
that there's still that instinct of a mother of just nah.
It's like nah, I'd love for you to stay, but also you kind of need to go.
Yeah, like we're getting like I'm being an adult, and it you know, it's just weird to still have to report to a parent.
Yeah, that's.
I can now convert Thunder Jaws.
Yes.
And Rock Breakers and other things. Now for the really hard part. Yeah. I have to get past the.
Yeah, when I watched
again.
Him.
Oh, fuck.
Do
this.
I died. On his own profile. It was him running out and then him screaming.
I was under leveled for that one, too.
Yeah.
I was like a level 25, and that's a level 32 motion.
That was a bullet just like whizzing past you, and you not even like walking back.
They have some shit. That is cool as shit. Whatever.
So, I guess I can do mine now. Well, what do I like? Escape death. Wow, we went up 3 levels in there.
Well, you know, that's what happens when you almost die.
Cool, you die or you die, kid. You either die or you die.
It's die
yeah,
or
I
die,
can...
kid. It's you either die.
So we can
or you
now
die.
Convert Thunderbirds, which is one of the strongest enemies in the game. Rock Breakers, which is one of the strongest enemies in the game.
Isn't that the giant ass?
They're like moles. They're
oh,
giant moles.
Mind.
Are they Rissetti?
I think we take Rissetti over them.
Oh, I wouldn't. Because, like, as we mentioned earlier, my Wii would overheat, and I'd play Animal Crossing. So it was always a very sad morning when halfway through taking care of my city, my Wii would overheat. And then like 10 minutes later, I'd only have like 5 minutes to play. I'd get the bells, you know, I'd just get as many bells as I could and save and fix it when I got home.
Do that up
and
later.
Every single time Rossetti was there, it's just like, I'm sorry, this was an accident. I have been careless.
Rossetti is like the most like you feel sorry when he talks to you, like he uses the like the perfect language to make you feel bad for what you did.
I actually am because of Rossetti. I'm always scared to hit that reset button because I'm mildly afraid that it will ruin that disc more than it will.
Or at worst case scenario, Rossetti will appear and chastise you. Rossetti definitely like felt like a chastising figure.
Actually, every time I played, I never owned Animal Crossing. Every time I played it or watched someone play it, it was at a daycare for after school.
Like, like a daycare, not like.
It was like an aftercare because I was. It was probably me grades. Oh gosh, when did I start growing? Probably 3rd through 6th. Or 7.
Well, I might be able to go through his games. Who knows?
Who knows? How about you go?
Alright, so I'm gonna actually pass this to Warrior so I can think. You might want to switch out of the trip cat, off of the rope caster, though. Switch to your bow. Not to your fire arrows, because those won't deal damage. So I did say Final Fantasy VI, and that was, I played that when I was really little. Little, but like I didn't really get into it until I was actually getting into middle school during actually actually kind of a really hard period in my life. Is when my parents' marriage was collapsing. Boo, wow, that's fun. Wow. And so I got to play that. And I snuck it at night because I wasn't allowed to do anything because I was a very horrible kid once upon a time. Don't fight that, you'll die.
How the fuck do I?
Stealth. Square.
Okay. Oh, and now see what a long leg is.
Final Fantasy VI.
Quick way down.
So the first game that I actually felt emotional over, and it's a good game. And we're gonna do it on the channel one day.
One day,
and that's gonna be a really important day for me. Because I could get
this. It's for the Game Boy, right?
No, it's for, I want to do the PlayStation version, because as extra bosses, I haven't fought.
Okay.
As much as I would like to play Fenix down, I would like some new shit for me.
Okay.
And I would like that to be, Colton and Ken, yeah, because, you know, two of my most.
I don't want the soggy carapace there.
Warrior, you're allowed to be there, but, like, you're not required to be there. I love you, though.